This Notion workspace has generated over 100 million views and hundreds of thousands of dollars in revenue across 3 YouTube channels. But more importantly, you could run all of it by yourself as a one-person business. And in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how it works. If you're new here, I'm Matty. I help creators build AI systems to scale their YouTube channels. And today, you're gonna get a behind-the-scenes look at what my content engine looks like inside of Notion. But if you'd rather skip the DIY process and all the trial and error, I've actually turned this exact system into a plug-and-play template called Content Engine. It also comes with video tutorials and access to our community of rebel creators who also support each other in growing on YouTube. The link is in the description if you want to check it out. Let's hop over to Notion. So this is the command center, the home base of my content engine. Each channel that I have has its own specific content engine. That way it just makes it easier to organize all of my different pieces of content. I also have a quick link at the top to get back to my YouTube channel whenever I need to, and also a link to the Google Drive folder where I upload all of my assets. Mine only has 3 sections. There is an idea matrix for getting ideas. There is this in production pipeline where I can see all the pieces of content that are currently in motion for every channel. And beneath that, the last section is just a database view showing a calendar so I can track all of the content pieces that are coming out across all of my channels at the month level. There's also this little don't delete toggle at the bottom here. It's in red, so I remember not to delete that. It contains all the databases that run my engine. And so if I deleted that, it would basically be like taking the engine out of my content engine. I guess I should have thought of that more. Maybe it should be like a content Lambo or something. And so the way that I've designed Content Engine is it mirrors the exact same workflow that I use to generate a YouTube video. And that goes from all the way from idea generation through the production pipeline and then scheduling and keeping track of them in my content calendar. I organize this dashboard to move top to bottom, left to right, exactly how you would read a book. And so with that in mind, let's go through the entire workflow, starting with the most important, but probably most overlooked aspect of the video creation process, which is coming up with a killer idea. And for that, we're gonna go ahead and expand the idea matrix here. I think I heard it from Patty Galloway, who's like known as the king of YouTube strategy. He said in an interview once that in order to come up with a really, really good idea, you have to go through a lot of bad ideas. Your first idea for a video is usually not gonna be your best one. And because it's such an important process for the success of any YouTube video and of course the growth of your YouTube channel, I try on a daily basis to generate at least 5 to 10 new ideas. And I'll simply just add those ideas to this idea matrix. I click on plus new here and I'll add my rough idea here, how to, produce a drum and bass track without a computer. And then inside Content Engine, you'll also see here, if I just expand this over a little bit, you can create a lot of different templates for the different types of content that you make. YouTube video is my most used one because I am a YouTuber at heart. So it's at the top here, but I also have templates for, you know, social media posts, carousels, shorts. But let's just say, for example, of this demonstration, this is gonna be a YouTube video. I'm just gonna click that and then it's gonna auto-populate a template for me. But hold that thought, we're gonna come back to this in just a second, because capturing an idea into your idea matrix is really just the first step. What separates a novice creator from someone who's been doing this for a long time, they validate the idea to make sure that it's going to perform well before they even move on with it. And so I have a process, like I said, reading a book, I run left to right in my database to validate, is this idea something that I want to pursue? And so for this piece of content here, the first thing I want to know is, how does this fit into my overall content strategy, my overall brand? Is this video serving a purpose of growth for my channel? Is it something more of a personality type of video? Or is it to help me build authority in my space? This one seems like it's going to build some more authority because I'm teaching them how to do something. Next, the concept of the video. How am I actually going to execute on this video? And I would just type my rationale here. Next column here is validation. Is there another YouTube video or creator or some reference that this idea might perform really well? And so designer is who is going to design this thumbnail. I'm gonna assign this one to Mike. If you work with an outside thumbnail designer, like an external contractor or something, add them to Notion. Easy enough to just put their name there. Next to that is the thumbnail status. I kind of view thumbnails and videos as like 2 separate projects going on at the same time. And so I like to have 2 separate status trackers for both of them, so I know when each of them are finished. And so finally, if that idea checks all the boxes for me, it has a good place in my strategy. I have a good concept for it. I validated it. I have a good thumbnail idea for it as well. I can click this button to approve that video and it'll move down into my production pipeline. You can see that this number just changed from 8 to 9. And if I expand this, we'll be able to see there that video is now in my production pipeline. So that is idea generation. Now you might be thinking this guy is full of crap because he said he generates a ton of ideas and you only see three of them here. Well, that's because I also have some custom formulas that are set up for all of my ideas where if I don't touch an idea for over a week and it just sits here in the idea matrix, that it actually moves over to this other tab here called old. So if I click on old, you'll be able to see there are actually a lot more ideas here that I have captured into my idea matrix and they're just not moved on with. It just goes on and on, and I can even load more, and it just keeps going on and on and on. And so that wraps up how to manage generating ideas in my content engine. Let's move on to developing and producing all the videos that are now in my pipeline. So this is the in production pipeline in Notion. One of my favorite ways to organize databases is by Kanban boards like this. You can simply just click and drag pieces of content like this and just move it over to the different stages of the process. So it'll be in the scripting phase, and then if it's ready to film, I'll move it here. And then once I film it, I'll move it over to filming, and then I'll prep it for my editors, and then I will edit the video myself. And when it's complete, it moves to complete. When it's scheduled, yada, yada, yada. And finally, it gets published. So I'm gonna open up this video into a full screen, so we have a bit more space here. At the top, I always wanna know the most important things about this video. What channel is it going for? Because I said I have multiple channels that I make videos for. The content status as well, the tentative release date for my videos. And then finally, when it has a public link, I'll add that here so that I can always get back to it as quickly as possible. I also always wanna see the concept of the idea that I'm working with and any validation for that video. And like I said, simplicity is key. The same way that I work through this video is just going top to bottom. So the first thing I'll do for videos is I'll usually package them. I think of different titles for them. I usually try to get at least five, sometimes even more. And then I highlight the ones I like best here. And then for thumbnails, I will also have a full thumbnail creation process. I want to ideate thumbnails. I have drafts for them. And I even have instructions for my editing team. And so that is packaging a video. I think very, very important to get the title, the thumbnail, and the concept of the video fleshed out before you move on to scripting. And so I actually don't script immediately. I like to outline my videos first. I'll, you know, brainstorm some points that I want to cover, maybe get the structure and flow of the video really set first, and then I move on to scripting. And that way, scripting doesn't feel like I'm just pulling ideas out of my brain out of nowhere, and it's more like filling in the blanks of an outline. And then after the video script is complete, then I'll go ahead and start prepping the video with a storyboard. Storyboards are things that I know they use in cinema, in the film industry, so that they can frame by frame plan out all the shots they want to get, all the editing choices, and all the design stuff. This has been incredibly, incredibly valuable now that I work with an outside agency to do video editing services. And so the editors can get quickly on board and they see exactly what is my vision for this video. They don't have to make guess decisions. They don't have to make guess edits. And it also saves a ton of time leaving feedback and also editing the video because I have a very clear plan of what it's going to look like. And then finally, once I have prepped this video out, you know, planning the hook, intro, loops, points I have, conclusion of the video, now it is ready for me to move on to the editing stage. Well, I can change the content status here to, you know, ready to film, filmed, prepped, and then editing, of course. So all that was pretty conceptual. Why don't I just show you an actual project that I have currently in the pipeline right now? I'm gonna go back to my content engine by clicking on the channel name. Let's open this to a full screen. And so let's just go ahead and see which video is almost done here. This one right here, Notion is becoming a super app. So we're talking about Notion, might as well show you guys this one. This is a project that's almost done. As you can see at the top here, it is scheduled to be released on Valentine's Day, which is actually tomorrow. Okay, well, hopefully that video is already out and you can go check it out as well. And you can kind of see the whole process come together here. You can see that in the titles area, I've brainstormed a few titles for this video. Here in the ideation step, we have different thumbnails that we're ideating for this video just to see which one might be the best for it. In the planning step, I had the outline of the video here where I outlined just some rough bullet points about what I thought all the points should be for this video. And then afterwards, I scripted it out and then I put all those scripts into my storyboard here for my editing team. And so you can see it just goes line by line, everything that I said in the video after I filmed it. And I tell my editors, this is my idea for the video. I think it should start off with some B-roll and some captions. I leave some explanations about what I think the edit should look like. And I also leave some reference images. Doing a little bit of planning up front like this can save so much time in posts. I can't even stress how valuable it's been to do it like this. And that, my friends, is the production pipeline. Now, this is where it gets really interesting. Because what happens if, like me, you manage multiple channels? Or maybe you are a social media manager and you have multiple clients that you work with. How on earth do do you use a system like this without losing your mind? Well, remember what I said earlier, how inside of every single content project, at the top, I have this channel relation property that links to what channel it comes from. And so if you click on it, you'll actually see that I have multiple different channels that I run. And what I've done is I actually have created a separate dashboard just to view the different channels that I have. And so I can click on at the top here, a link to my content channels. We'll be able to see all the different content channels that I have. Here's my main YouTube channel. Here's our Mike and Matty channel, where we go deeper on AI systems for creator businesses, our newsletter, our Rebel Creator newsletter, and then our music studio channel. And so let's just open up Mike and Matty, for example. And you can see these channels follow the exact same layout and format of all my other channels, right? That way it just keeps things very simple. If you learn one system, you can learn all the systems. Each of these channels have their own idea matrices and the production pipeline of different content pieces that are working through them as well. And so that way I can stay super organized and manage multiple channels at the same time. And so now let's go ahead and move on to the last section here, which is the content calendar itself. And so this is just the same database with all of the different content pieces. And I can just see from a bird's eye view, from a month view, what are all the pieces of content that are coming out, right? So tomorrow, like I said, we have two pieces of content coming out. I can see what channel they're coming from. One's coming out on the Mike and Matty channel. One's coming out on the Koi channel. I can see the status as well of what that piece of content is in the pipeline. So this one's done, it's ready to go. This one is editing. So I'll probably have to reach out to my editing team just to make sure that things are on track for this to come out tomorrow. And for whatever reason, if maybe this video isn't gonna come out tomorrow, I can always just click and drag it to move it to a different date where it might actually be on time, just like that. And then finally, probably one of my most favorite things about this content engine, because I am someone who loves seeing progress and doing things over a long time, you can really get to see the fruits of your labor. And so let's just go back to the Koi channel here, and I'm gonna go down to my calendar here. I've created a separate view in the calendar called gallery. And this way I can just see all of the pieces of content that have come out for this channel. I'll have this really cool library of content that shows everything that I've ever done on YouTube. And this just, as you can see, you can load more, it just keeps going back. The longer you do this, the more your library is gonna grow. And hopefully that should motivate you and inspire you to just keep going, to keep building and adding on to this list of content. And so my friends, that is the complete system, my content engine from idea to a published video across multiple channels. All of it lives in Notion in one place. And now here's something really interesting that has kind of emerged from me having this content engine. Because using a tool like Notion that has a lot of integrations with other tools, you can use AI automations like through make.com or Zapier, and even start daisy chaining AI prompts together, where you can basically turn your content creation process into a self-sustaining cycle. I'm talking about like 10x, even like 100x improvements in productivity, in both quality and quantity, right? Not just pumping out shallow content. Those are the AI systems that we're helping creators and founders install to their own business to build content engines. And so if that interests you, I'll also leave a link in the description to check it out. It also might like this video over here, where I also share some really interesting ways that I'm using AI to create content.